The one thing I would say to investors is don't judge anything in your returns or your assets in nominal terms, in terms of how many dollars you have. View it in terms of inflation adjusted dollars. And so cash, like this year, you'll lose 4 or 5% to inflation. And so pay attention to those, because I believe that that'll be the worst investment.
I got to ask you before we let you go about crypto. You told CoinDesk you own some, even though you said you thought it was going to get killed by regulation. How much Bitcoin do you own? Do you have any other cryptocurrencies? And what do you think the outlook is for them now?
Well, I'm not going to give the precise amount of Bitcoin or that I do own some Ethereum as well. But the answer to your question is that I don't own a lot of it. I view it as alternative money in a environment where the value of cash money is depreciating in real terms. And I think it's very impressive that for last 10, 11 years, that programming has still held up. It hasn't been hacked and so on, and it has an adoption rate. So I'm very big on diversification, and it's a relatively small part of the portfolio. I would like to say that cash, I've been quoted, cash is trash, cash, which most investors think is the safest investment, is, I think, the worst investment, and that it's important because it loses buying power. The one thing I would say to investors is don't judge anything in your returns or your assets in nominal terms, in terms of how many dollars you have. View it in terms of inflation adjusted dollars. And so cash, like this year, you'll lose 4 or 5% to inflation. And so pay attention to those, because I believe that that'll be the worst investment. And then beyond that, the important thing is to diversify one's portfolio well, because we know from that the surprises and the balance. We also know that those asset classes on average significantly outperform and will significantly outperform cash, and that they move between each other in a way that one that has to do with correlations, because of when things go down, when the economy goes down, then bonds will do better than stocks and so on and so forth. So diversification of assets. I view crypto as a small piece of that. And the message is cash is gonna be a problematic asset, and hold that other diversified portfolio of assets. Keeping looking at it in real terms, not nominal terms, and that diversification should be also international diversification from countries, not just asset classes, in order to have a truly well-diversified portfolio.
Quickly on inflation, Ray, how concerned are you about it?
I'm significantly concerned about it because the amount of money and credit that has to be produced, right, and is budgeted is a large increase. And yet, if it's not spent, it produces its own problems. The markets have a sensitivity to that. So what it means, and then there's a supply-demand picture for bonds. And the way it looks is if you should get the selling of bonds, it worsens that supply-demand picture, because the way it works is the Treasury borrows and runs a deficit, but it can't produce money. So it has to sell bonds. And when it sells bonds, if there are not enough buyers of those bonds, then the Federal Reserve got to come in and print money and buy those bonds. And the world right now is over invested in US dollar denominated bonds, pension funds on the 60-40 mix, and they have negative real returns. And cash has a lot of negative real returns. So if there was a selling of that and a moving to other assets, stocks, other assets, commodities, other assets, or other places, other currencies, other real estate and the like, that selling worsens the supply-demand picture. And then if there's not enough demand, that means that the central bank has got to come in and print more money. So yes, it's not only the inflation that's in the pipeline or projected in that supply-demand balance, but it's also what it could be if there's a selling of debt instruments.